Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around. Today, we're going to be looking at one of the seven wonders of the universe, the starter motor. It does have something to do with the square of electrical fun. Purpose of the starter motor is not to start your car, contrary to popular belief. Purpose of the starter motor is to rotate the engine so that your car can start. It's just easier than hand cranking, like I had to when I was a kid. To figure out how this puppy works, we need to take it apart. Well, that was easier than expected. All right, so we want to make this thing turn. It's a motor. We want to make it rotate. We want to make it happen for us. And if you remember in level one, when we looked at the square of electrical fun to find out how our ignition system worked, we discovered that if you want movement, we need to have electricity going through loops, which create a magnetic field, and that has to oppose another magnetic field, so the two magnets are trying to push against each other. That's how a motor works. And you'll notice, ain't no magnets here. So, we need to create a magnetic field so that we can have movement when we put electricity through another set of loops. So what we have to do is find two sets of loops. Yep, there's one staring you in the face. This one? No, you silly man, it's the one with the wires. Oh, this one? Yes! What's wrong with you? Okay, so there are loops of wire in here, and this part is called the armature because it is the part that rotates. I don't know why they don't call it a rotator. Yuck, 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 yuck. And it looks like each one of these loops has its own connector. How very odd. Where would we find the other set of loops? Can you think of something else that might have another set of electrical loops? Might have some wires. Something else that might have some wire. Can you see wires in anything else on the table? No, it's not that. I'm not sure why you would even point. It's a little hard to see because they're all covered in goop. But there's a loop of wire all around that crazy pole inside there, and there's a loop of wire all around that, and 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 a loop of wire. That's too many. You're right. Now, you may remember from level one, when we looked at making a magnetic field stronger, we could put metal in it. So there's metal in the middle of these loops to make it a stronger magnetic field. Magnets like to travel through steel way better than air. To have this thing give us motion, I need to have two loops of wire that both have magnetic fields. We found a loop of wire here and a loop of wire here. If they can create a magnetic field, they should be able to oppose each other. This one has one connection here, which will eventually go to the battery. And so electricity can come in here and energize these magnetic fields inside here. They're also connected, you can see connected here and there. They're sending positive to these two guys right there. This one is going to go to negative, this one goes positive. That'll create the magnetic field. Positive is going to here. Those connect to this. Positive will come to two different sets of loops. When the magnetic field is on and the magnetic field is on, these two repel, this thing turns. Think about that. Look at this. If electricity is going to go to this connection and create a magnetic field, and that magnetic field repels another magnetic field and makes this rotate, it'll break that connection and now engage this one, which now turns on its magnetic field, tries to repel, breaks the connection, engages this one. It tries to repel, breaks the connection, engages this one. It tries to repel, breaks the connection, engages that one. And just keeps going, 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 super, super, super fast. It's the constant turning on and turning off and turning on and turning off of these magnetic fields that make it continue to rotate. So I got a magnetic field in here, repelling the magnetic fields that we turn on and turn off in here. Question though, I can't just have this starter spinning. If we look at this end, the gear end here is not constantly engaged in the flywheel of the motor. It sits out unengaged and the flywheel sits over here when the engine's running. If you want to start it, you turn the key, this thing pukes out, and then it rotates. Question, how do I get this to rotate after it's engaged? How can I make this hit the flywheel, join the teeth, and then turn on?
Has it got something to do with that orange thing?
What makes you say that?
Well, it had that weird wishbone thing connected to it.
You are correct. This thing, when we first had it assembled, sat up top kind of like this, This sat in here like so. Oh, that's weird. What do you think this is for? I can make this move. Let's put it back in the front and see what it does. So this thing sat in the front of the starter like this. Can you see what it's trying to do here? Look at how this moves back and how this can move forward. So it kind of sits in the nose like this. For this thing to drive out, this part has to be shoved in. What has to be going on inside here? Yep. Zebras. Close. Yep.
And magnetics.
Yes. Where's it going to get the magnetic from?
Zebras.
Nope. Oh, is it a magnetic field and loops and all that square of electrical fun? You are right. I can't really take this one apart too well, but if we look at this guy, inside is a loop of wires. If I put electricity through there, what am I going to create?
Magnetic field.
Nice. Put a piece of steel in here, it'll probably get sucked in from that magnetic force. That's what's happening in this one. The magnetic field is created and this piece of steel is going to get sucked into it. That's going to pull that lever, shove that into the flywheel. But I can't have this thing rotating yet until this thing is engaged. How can I time that? How can I get electricity to shove that in the flywheel and then turn this on? Might have something to do with this. Yep. Could there be a switch in the bottom of it? Yes, there is. Let's see if we can see one. So on this solenoid, if I take this solenoid apart, inside it looks like this. There's a disc right here. This thing moves. We don't want to have like 200 amps of electricity go through your steering column. The voltage coming from your key is a fairly small amount of current. It's going to go to here. It goes to here, creates a magnetic field inside. That magnetic field pulls the piston inside. When that piston comes along, this comes up, hits this, and this. This one goes to the battery. So it's like a mechanically operated switch. No juice going to the starter. Click. Now we have the battery connected to the windings, which now feed everything else and make it rotate. And as it pulls in, that lever goes, this gets shoved into the flywheel. When that disc makes the connection, electricity now goes from the battery through here into the windings on the housing and the armature. The magnetic fields repel each other and this thing starts to move. Sometimes, and it doesn't happen often, but sometimes the starter might engage and stay stuck with the flywheel, and now you have a potential issue on your hands, because while this will crank the engine at around 400 RPM or less, if I'm now cruising at like 4000 RPM, I'm spinning this 10 times faster than it used to go. Any of you guys done skateboarding? Yeah, anybody fall off the skateboard and realize you can't actually run that fast? It's called the Texas two-step. It never ends well. This is going to rotate one heck of a lot faster than it was designed to. They can't explode. So there's a safety device in this so it doesn't grenade. I'm going to pass this around and you're going to have a look-see and see if you can make it work for you. Here you go.
I'm not finding it.
This thing turns in one direction.
I think you're tripping, Mr. Wellwood. Here's your silly tool back.
Thank you.
This thing was turning. It slips in one direction, but it grabs in the other direction. So when this thing is rotating, this is designed to rotate in this direction, it's going to grab and turn the flywheel. But if the flywheel turns faster, and this thing doesn't disengage, it's on a spiral gear to try and kick it back in. But let's say it doesn't go back in for whatever drunken reason, this thing will slip, so we don't spin this faster than we have to. Assembling these are pretty straightforward. In fact, just like alternators, the rebuild kits are pretty stupid simple. On this one, I just kind of get a little medieval. Some starters have like four sets of brushes, and that's just a pain to do. Come on, you wee rubber. Be submissive. Ugh, your mother was a Fiat Panda. All right, and that thing would connect right there with a nut to hold it. A couple big long bolts hold it all together, and she's ready to go. Woohoo! No more hand cranking our car today. Subscribe and leave a comment below if you hand crank your own cars. Thanks for watching.